Hey guys, I'm Pranav Shastri and in today's video, I'm going to be showing you how to install the cylindrical door lock, which is popularly in use nowadays. So as you can see, this is our door and the old lock on this door broke. So I decided to paint it and repair the door wherever it was damaged. And now this is how it looks after painting and my repair work. And then I installed the stainless steel fixtures to the door. So this is how it looked after installing all the SS fixtures. So as you can see, this is our round lock which is manufactured by Doorset. I bought this model of the lock which was the nearest match to the old lock installed on the door by our builder in the apartment in 2005. Upon opening the box, we find the lock unit itself which comes pre-assembled. Then we have one set of three keys. Then this is the strike which will be installed to the door frame. So here is an instruction manual, but this one is for my particular model. However, you can have a look at it once for your reference. So then here we have the cutout jamb for the strike unit. So here we have the door latch which will be connected with the main door lock unit. So this is our main lock unit, as you can see. This is the inner side and this is the lock side, that is the outer side. Also in the box we have a wrench for opening the knobs of the lock and also some screws. As you can see, this is the wrench which we will use to open the knob. So we are going to take the inner side, as you can see, from where we control the locking mechanism. And you can see there is a tiny hole here where there is a push lever given. So you have to push that using the wrench or any other nail or a pencil or a pen, and simultaneously push the knob outwards. As you can see, in this manner it will come out. And then we can remove the escutcheon, as you can see. So basically how it works is, there are clamps given at the top and bottom of the latch unit which slide in with the lock unit, and then the mechanism is controlled. So when you rotate the knob, the latch also moves. So this is my house diagram, and as you can see, we are going to be installing the round lock in the utility balcony. So the keyhole side will come outwards, that is towards the balcony, and the lock control, the button side, will go inside, that is towards the kitchen area. So as you can see, that should line up with this hole in this manner. So now we are going to take our latch unit and slide it in here through this hole made in the door. As you can see, that basically works like that. And when you push it, these two prongs come out from here. So now we are going to line up the main lock unit, and basically it has to clamp together. So as you can see, it clamps in this manner. So when you rotate the knob, the latch accordingly moves. As you can see, the clamp moving. This is the correct method of installation. This is the wrong method where it does not clamp, as you can see. So now you can see basically the principle is understood and it's completed. So now we are going to take the escutcheon which we had previously removed using the wrench, and we are going to separate the mounting plate from it. This is our mounting plate, and we are going to slide it in and line up the two screw holes with the screw brackets given inside. And we are going to take the thread kind of screw, as you can see. We are going to use two for this here. So as you can see, we have tightened it. So now we are going to take our screw packet and take out two screws which are for the wooden surface or wall plug. As you can see, the long thread kind of screws, and we are going to secure the latch bolt with it. And now is the time to adjust your lock accordingly. You can adjust the lock on the keyhole side by rotating the escutcheon in or outwards. So that will accordingly bring the lock in or out on that side, and it will leave more or less space on the other side as well. After the adjustments, you can take the escutcheon, and as you can see, there is a notch which has to line up with this part. And once you have lined it up, you can slightly give it a tap and fit it in place. So now we will take the knob unit, and as you can see, there is a groove made, and we will line up this mark along with the groove, and we will gently push it in place, and then we will hit and fit the knob. As you can see, it is done now. So now we are going to install the strike to the door frame. My previous lock installed did not have the groove cut, so I will be making the new groove here. As you can see, now I will install the cutout jamb for the box strike, and now I will be installing the strike itself. So now we have two long thread screws left, using which we will be securing our strike to the door frame tightly. As you can see, it is done, and now we will be peeling off the protector. And as you can see, here is our nice stainless steel finish lock. And we will be doing the same to the latch unit as well. So as you can see, we have successfully completed installing our round lock. So here is the round lock operation explained. That is, when you lock it from the inside, you cannot open it from the outside without the key. So we have successfully installed and commissioned our round lock. If you have any doubts or encountered any difficulty while installing your lock, please do comment and I will try my best to clarify your doubt. Please like this video and do subscribe to our channel if you found this video helpful. Also, a video on how to dismantle your round lock will be released soon, which will help you in removing your old lock for installing the new one. So thanks for watching.